The road to the first ever WrestleMania continues. Thanks for tuning in to another special episode of Tyler Vance Rants. I am your host, Tyler Vance himself, and you're not. It's March 8th, 1985. Last week, we got to know a little bit more about the first female referee of the World Wrestling Federation in Rita Marie. Classy Freddie Blassie vowed that both his men, the Iron Sheik and Nikolai Volkoff, would become the new WWF Tag Team Champions when they inevitably face off against the American Express of Barry Windham and Mike Rotundo. And Dr. D, David Schultz, made one of, if not his final, appearance on WWF TV. Both Vince McMahon and Lord Awful Alfred Hayes host TNT once again, and immediately bring out their first guests. Rowdy Roddy Piper, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, and Cowboy Bob Orton.
Thank you, wonderful. Yeah, the band hasn't been practicing at all. Did you notice that?
Ever since narrowly avoiding arrest by the NYPD in Madison Square Garden back at the war to settle the score, Vince McMahon gets off to a horrible start by stating that Piper, Orndorff, and Orton all must be looking over their shoulders due to the actions they undertook, specifically against the WWF champion Hulk Hogan, pop star Cyndi Lauper, and of course, Mr. T. So it's gonna be one of those nights, is it, Vinny? Well, two can play at that game. None of the trio are at all concerned with what they did at the war to settle the score. But you, McMahon, should be concerned about the next words your filthy sewer utters. Realizing that he's failed to get a rise out of his guests, McMahon then changes tact, stating that the match Roddy Piper had with WWF champion Hulk Hogan was,
"Would you say that that's the toughest match you've ever had?"
Yeah, listen to him, huh? Are you kidding me? You're talking about complete full control.
McMahon continues to fire on all cylinders, next taking aim at the Cowboy, harassing Orton for,
"Apparently, you ask Cowboy Bob Orton to interject himself into the match."
Are you having a bad day, Vince? Well, good, but don't take your self-hatred out on your guests, and at least try to have a shred of journalistic integrity going forward. Okay, pal?
I never asked him to interject himself in the match. He was trying to point something out to the referee.
Well, what prompted you to come out of Madison Square Garden, and what right did you have to interfere
in a match? This man was down, he's hurt. Look at his wrist, he's got a broken wrist. Mr. T jumps up in the ring. It's Roddy Piper against Hulk Hogan and Mr. T. Rock and roll world is on our case. Everywhere we go, nobody likes us.
I like you, Mr. Wonderful. In fact, I would say you're in the top 10 of current wrestlers that I support, alongside your two comrades there. Who cares if the single-digit IQ animals that comprise the idiotic masses which call themselves wrestling fans don't like you? It all comes down to a single point. They're jealous of you and your success, and instead of looking inward and changing direction in their meaningless lives, they'd rather pull from the Vince McMahon book of self-hatred and attack every single person around them and place the blame solely at everyone else's feet. You three gentlemen are better off without them.
When you got a body like this and a face like this, you can do any damn thing you want to do, and I'll get away with it.
Rowdy Roddy Piper and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff will face off against the WWF champion Hulk Hogan and Mr. T at WrestleMania's main event on March 31st. But let's be honest, we already know how this match is going to play out. Hogan will go on to be dragged down by his inexperienced actor friend and be humiliated across the world in front of millions. The only choice from there will be to retire from both pro wrestling and acting for the Hulkster and Mr. T respectively.
They're like vultures, you know, trying to get in on our business. Well, you got that souped up spider monkey. He did stick his nose in our business. He's black, he's greasy, and I don't like him.
Now, I'm not sure if you knew this about Mr. T, but he has a background as a bodyguard and also competed in and won several strongman competitions. While certainly impressive, it does not change the fact that Mr. T himself is nothing more than a cartoon character, and his lack of experience in the combat zone, as he calls it, will amount in nothing but failure. Vince McMahon next interviews the Junkyard Dog, but fear not, we have not seen the last of Roddy Piper, Paul Orndorff, and Bob Orton. Instead, we have to suffer through Vince McMahon attempting to rebuild his image as a credible journalist, asking the Dog what he contributes to his in-ring success.
I've come a long way in the last past 6 months from down south. I was laid down south for about 5.5 years and finally I got to what I call the top.
Alongside the main event of WrestleMania, there will of course be other high-profile matches to enjoy. One of the matches will feature the mangy mutt himself, as he looks to rip the WWF Intercontinental Championship from Greg the Hammer Valentine's possession.
You know, like they say, every dog needs a bone to chew on. I found myself a natural bone.
They also say every dog has his day, but it's a shame that March 31st won't be yours.
March 31st, the papers got it, man.
You know what's so funny about this, T, man? The whole world knows about this, man. This is a good place to get started, T, but you've eaten so many tacos already today.
Man, I want to get one more, man. One more taco and hot bowl of chili, man. That makes me me. First, I want to go to Senorita, you know, Sanchez, to get me a good taco, man, like I always get. It's the last one.
It's the last one.
For the Piper and Orndorff, you dead meat. You dead meat, and I pity you, fool.
Of course it's another training montage. It wouldn't be the 1980s without it. Shout out to Mean Gene Okerlund's drip here. Let's make tuxedo tops and board short bottoms a thing again in 2024.
And once we get done training, this dude's gonna teach me how to street fight.
There's a comeback zone. We're gonna stay hungry, man. That's what we're gonna do.
All right, let's see this, ladies and gentlemen.
And I pity the fool.
That's right. Oh.
When it comes crashing down.
I told you that we hadn't seen the last of Rowdy Roddy Piper, Cowboy Bob Orton, nor Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, as the trio are back alongside Sarah the Soothsayer.
Not our fault, Mrs. Hogan can't afford to eat.
This is not Mrs. Hogan.
As a soothsayer, Sarah is in touch with the spirits and can know things that have happened, things that are, and things that may yet come. So it's unsurprising to me that Vince McMahon asked the soothsayer how the main event of WrestleMania will turn out. Now, I don't want to spoil the match for you, and especially considering it hasn't even happened yet, but I already know the outcome, as I stated earlier. So it makes me wonder, maybe I have the gift of soothsaying. But anyways, it's just a relief to know that Sarah wasn't a fake.
Spirits, come,
whoa, baby.
Come, spirit, come
yes, huh?
To me. At this point, it looks good for Roddy. Yes, he's got Mr. T
maybe
and a hammer.
Something.
You must be careful, Paul. You must be strong.
Strong.
Oh, he is strong.
You're strong.
At the war to settle the score, Leilani Kai dethroned WWF Women's Champion Wendi Richter, under the guidance and tutelage of a former WWF Women's Champion herself, the Fabulous Moolah. Both master and student are Vince McMahon's next guests on TNT. It was a foregone conclusion that Leilani Kai was going to be able to walk away with the WWF Women's Championship, especially considering to counter the expert guidance of the Fabulous Moolah, Wendi Richter brought in that pop star Cyndi Lauper. That would be like Hulk Hogan choosing to team with an actor rather than an experienced professional wrestler in his tag team match against Rowdy Roddy Piper and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Idiotic! Sure, there may have been controversy ringside, especially considering Lauper provoked Moolah into defending herself, but it is not Kai's fault that Richter opted to aid the pop star rather than finish off her then challenger. Wendi Richter should just focus on getting good. Now that the two have a rematch for the WWF Women's Championship coming up at WrestleMania on March 31st, Vince McMahon wants to know how Leilani Kai feels about having to face off against Wendi Richter yet again.
I'm the queen of the square circle. I have this belt, and I'm going to keep it around my waist, and there's no way she'll ever see it around her waist again. I have her next to my side. That's all I need.
It's a true champion speaking. That's all.
The Fabulous Moolah finishes the interview off with some interesting words, promising that she has something special in store for Cyndi Lauper, while also admitting that her protege, Leilani Kai, may have something special in store for Wendi Richter as well. I can't wait.
They need to get it together, and they better stop jacking their jaws on the crazy songs about girls want to have fun.
That brings us to the end of this week's TNT. But before you go, Lord Awful Alfred Hayes unveils that there will be a great wrestling trivia challenge starting this week and will continue for the next two editions of TNT. The first question is,
what prominent wrestler sampled a hot dog on TNT?
If you think you know what the answer is, let me know down in the comments below, and we'll see if you have what it takes to win the Great Wrestling Trivia Challenge. It's lucky for you that I've covered every single episode of TNT up until this point, so if you're not sure of the answer, now is a perfect time to go back and watch those episodes. You might as well also hit the bell, like the video, and subscribe so you can stay up to date with everything pro wrestling circa 1985. You can also follow me on social media and live life to the fullest like it's the mid-80s in pro wrestling all over again. That's all for now. So long. As well as has But it's not Kai's fault that Richter choosed what? You might as well also like the bell. Like the bell. Why do I always say like the bell? I like the bell. You, please click bell.